Sweden.
Oh, right in time.
Presented by Brian Soderberg, who himself is directly from Sweden. And the Swedish national anthem, Du gamla du fria, will now be sung. And of course, if you know it, please
sing along, baby.
Sing along.
I can.
Do it.
American.
Well, American.
It's the Anders
term. Well, you're supposed to do that.
Was also a high status item. Not many warriors had them, unless you were quite well off. The round shield was the most typical type, and they would. They have been rebated, which means they've been dulled a bit, but they'd still hurt quite a bit if you got hit. Vikings were traders. The best steel in the world came from Persia, and what they found is some of the high status swords were actually came from Persian steel that was traded through Arab intermediaries and made it all the way out west. The things you can do is go to the all thing. And you could challenge a person to armed combat, usually to the death.
Ha!
Now the Vikings used to have spring assemblies for all things. And it was kind of a cross between a county fair and a court of law. One third of the law was recited every year, and everybody was required to be in attendance. And old scores and blood feuds could be settled there too. They had mechanisms for trying to limit blood feuds though. If you were involved in a killing, you'd gather up 12 of your neighbors and you'd confess the death blow. The next spring assembly, you bring the 12, and then you confess your deed, and you had an opportunity to buy yourself out of trouble. It's called a wargeld. The family could accept it or not. If they didn't accept it, then you could be banished for 3 years, and you're outside the law. That's why that's why Eric the Red had to leave Norway for 3 years. Then he got banished from Iceland. So he spent 3 years touring the coast, waiting for that law to lift. In the sagas, they do talk about female warriors. There was one brother and sister in particular that were very ruthless. There was a famous Arab chronicler by the name of Ibn Fadlan that talked about the ferocity of the Norse that he met in Baghdad. He said that amongst themselves they were quarrelsome and oftentimes led to battles to the death. But when faced with a common foe, they fought as if they were one organism.
He has 2 ears, 2 ears, and he has a curly tail, 2 ears, 2 ears, and he has a curly tail, and he goes, no, 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 no. So we're gonna walk in this direction, we're just gonna just dance in this direction, and then everybody's gonna come into the middle of the circle. So he comes
yeah,
this way.
Yeah, that's how you do it.
And he goes back out that way. And then he falls into a ditch. So everybody go down.
Yes.
And then you come up.
I haven't done it since I was little,
though. And then we go out again.
Yeah.
And then you fall into a ditch. Okay.
Might not have been so bad.
I might be out of time on that. We might be one more time in. All right, please go.
Do it, babes.
Boy wants to ride. He doesn't have anybody driving.
Boy.
And then it's, you think that you are pretty? I don't think so.
This is Swedish. Norwegian sounds so happy.
And now you're from Hopland. These folks are doing the Yance Polka.